Following a guilty plea, his ex-wife sits in prison, and a man charged with his murder awaits trial. But since his death in 2010, a shroud of mystery has surrounded the investigation into Lorenzen Wright's murder.
News Channel 3 has been on the story every step of the way from the moment Lorenzen stepped on his first high school basketball court until today. Now we are retracing his story and going further in depth. And two of the journalists behind WREG's new podcast are with us this morning, April Thompson and Zanetta Lowe. Welcome, ladies. Always good to see you.
Thank you.
This story, the Lorenzen story, has attracted not only attention here in Memphis and the Mid-South, but national attention along the many interviews that you've done. And I know you've interviewed at least 40 people, if not more. What are you finding now? What's the connecting point of all of this?
That there is still a lot of interest in this story, that the Lorenzen Wright story is a story not just in Memphis, that a lot of people around the country are interested in it because of his ties with the NBA. We know him from the hometown guy, but a lot of people knew him from the NBA, and a lot of people that we talked to were ready to talk about this because they remembered his story. Some of them still had a lot of questions about what really happened. And up until last week or so, we didn't know a lot about for sure what happened, and we expected that to come out in the trial. And because 48 Hours had profiled this story as well, a lot of other outlets had profiled it, a lot of people knew about it. So there is definitely a lot of interest, even though it had been 10 years after the fact that he was found, and then the arrest and the weapon being found. There was still a lot of interest in the story, so that made this interesting.
And those of us in the media here, of course, feel like we know so much about it. But as you've done these interviews, what was the thing that most surprised you? Whether it was something from his childhood or...
Yeah, well, I think there's a lot of that because we literally retrace his steps back to the days before he was born, before he was even thought of. What you'll hear a lot about, especially in the first episode, is his family life and his parents, Deborah Marion and Herbert Wright, how they met, their early days, how they were raised as children. So one of the things we learned was you've heard all these stories about Lorenzen and how he always had his family and friends around him. Well, we learned very early on how and why that part of his personality was shaped, that sense of loyalty that literally carried him, I'd say, almost up until, really up until the day he died.
And why his kids were so important.
Yes, and why his kids were so important. And we also learned things about, and you'll hear about this much later in the episodes, things that happened later on in his life leading up to literally, we retraced probably about the last 48 hours of his life. And then maybe questions from close family and friends about why maybe they weren't talked to as much by police. So questions there as well.
One thing I'm fascinated by also is not only obviously what people were saying about Lorenzen, but love her or hate her, what about Cheryl Wright? How does she fit into all of this? Were people very vocal about her? Were they reluctant to talk with you about it? Or what are you finding so far?
She's a big part of this podcast. And not only do we tell the Lorenzen Wright story, but also the Cheryl Wright story, who she was growing up in Westwood as a student at Westwood High School.
Who was she?
The Cheryl Robinson story.
Yeah, who was she?
She's a girl who grew up in Westwood, seemed to be very fun-loving, a big personality. She lost her mother as a teenager and how that affected her. But you asked a question about whether people were reluctant to share. People were reluctant to share on the record. We've talked to a number of people off the record and on background, and we talked to some on the record that you're going to hear from that you've never heard from before. Because understand this, you said lover or hater. The last picture that everyone saw of her was her latest mugshot. Well, we always have to remember, she was also someone's child, someone's daughter, someone's sister before Cheryl Robinson became Cheryl Wright, now the woman sitting in prison. So we also tried to learn that
and
about her.
In her guilty plea, she did share some things that maybe don't throw Lorenzen Wright, true or false, into the best light. It, oftentimes in a case like this, it's very easy to make the victim a hero. Do you
What was touch very enlightening was? About that, and you'll find out when you listen to the podcast, is how other people describe their relationship. and whether they saw some of the things that Shara is now claiming, because none of us had heard that.
So you dig into that.
Right.
We did not know some of the things that were brought out then.
Right.
But when we talk about their relationship, you're going to see a different side of their
Very
relationship.
Very quickly here, what's coming out officially today? Is this only just one chapter, or how does this podcast concept work?
The way it will work, and you're seeing it there, the title is Killing Lorenzen, Love, Basketball, Murder. It will be told episode by episode, week by week. And so go ahead and make sure wherever you can go to WREG.com or wherever you get your podcast, the best way is to subscribe so you'll find out when we're going to release a new episode. But it'll mainly it'll be weekly, and you may get them as we get close to the trial. We may have to do some.
And then they're like
different
links?
Yes, they're all different links. Mm-hmm. They'll range from 30 minutes to an hour. So that's the other beautiful part of this. We get way more time to talk about the story than we'd
ever depth,
get.
In-depth coverage.
On television.
Trailer is out now. You can find out what it's all about. You can go to wherever you get your podcast from. It's on iTunes, it's on Spotify, Android, and you can get it and listen to the trailer and then the first episode, and we'll continue to bring them out.
You're paving the way for Channel 3 into a whole new, that's kind of
cool. Also want to thank Boo Mitchell.
Oh, yes, most definitely.
Original music from Boo Mitchell and Uriah Mitchell, so it was a Memphis
story. And Alex,
story.
Thank you for your input.
And we wanted a Memphis music connection.
A lot of people.
All right, ladies, looking forward to checking out your podcast.
Mm-hmm.